Hi, welcome to another video from Robojax. In this video, I'm going to explain what a servo is and how you can use a servo in Arduino for robotics purposes. So as you can see here, we have a small servo. There are different type of servo. The servo has three wires. It needs power. As you can see here, the middle one is red, and then this is a darker one, brown, or sometimes you will see it as black. This is the negative. This is the 5 volts, the red one. And this orange is the signal. These two send the voltage to give them power. And through this one, you're sending a pulse width modulation to control the angle of a servo. So what a servo is, it has a motor inside it, a servo motor, and this rotates about 180 degrees. So it rotates 180 degrees by controlling the motion of this. You can open, close something, or move or arm of a robot or something. It usually the servos will come with different arms that can be attached to it. For example, you can attach some, if you need to control two parts of something, you can connect a string or a rod here through these holes, or here, and or maybe adjust it at different values, a different length from the center. So this is called the radius, and this will be attached, and then this can be installed somewhere. As you can see, I'm moving it with hand. If you just remember this point, now it just goes 180 degrees, so it can come back, but it doesn't go full rotation. Or if you just need half of it, if you don't need the other side, you can just use this one. So the servo is very useful for a lot of application in robotics. Let's get started and run it practically. Okay, to open the servo, the default servo project, which is within the so click on File, Examples, and then depending on your application, so somewhere at the bottom you should see servo. And servo has two built-in knob and sweep, so we go through both. Let's go to the knob. And here, this is a project. And quick explanation, it needs a servo library, a header that's included. You don't worry about it because all Arduino application comes with it. And this is called the object of the type servo is created, and then pin 0, or you can type A0, that is also referring to the pin 0 of your Arduino analog pin. So this is connected to the potentiometer. So what we do is we will rotate the potentiometer, so, and then we control the servo. Servo will rotate as we rotate the potentiometer. I've connected the 5 volts to this 5 volts of breadboard, so I have 5 volts everywhere, and then I've connected the ground to the ground. So the 5 volts and ground are available here. So this is done, the first part. And then the servo. The servo has 3 pin. So the brown one on this side is connected to the negative. This side is the negative. And then the middle one, which is connected to the red, to the 5 volts. So the servo is getting this 5 volts. This is done now, but the servo will not function until it receives the pulse width modulation signal here. And the pulse width modulation signal is coming from pin 9. And the pin 9 is here. It says on the application, if you see it here, this is if the 9 that which is coming to the servo. And then here, this reads the pin out, which is A9, so it reads analog. The value will be the value of from 0 to 1023. So that's the value. This function is called map. Maps the value from 0 to 1023 of the value will be mapped between 0 and 80. And then we will have a new value, and the new value will write or send it to the servo, the new value. And we have 15 millisecond delay here. Let me upload the sketch to my board. As you can see now, this is blinking. It was the original blink, now TXRX is running. So the code has been uploaded, but the servo is not doing anything. And this side is connected, one is to 5 volts, the other one is to 0. So here the gray is 5 volts and the black on this side is at the 0. And the middle one I've connected it to analog 0, to A0. That is connected. Let me connect the servo here. Now this is the servo and now I'm rotating it. See, when I rotate this, the servo also rotates. This was just a testing of how the servo works, or maybe if you have some steering wheel or something that you can connect, or something that you can control with a potentiometer. Now let me just run. As I rotate this to the left and right, I'm controlling it with 180 degrees. Okay, if this is 0, then your 180 will be here. And now I'm rotating it to the left. As you can see, it goes to around 180. And here, this is not 180 because this potentiometer is not going at full 0 or full maximum value. But it is responding perfectly. So that is directly relating to the angle. If you want to get that angle and do something for a specific angle, for some specific reading or calculation, you want to move it to a specific angle, you can do this as well. So let me just remove this from potentiometer and let's just put the servo for the values. I'm removing this now. Just comment this. So we can directly send here a value without a potentiometer. So I'm removing the potentiometer now. And let's say we want to put it at 0. So 0, let's upload it. So that is the 0. Now, let me just hold this and make it 180. And run the code. So it should come on this side. So that is 180. So if I make it 90 degrees, it should be somewhere here. That is how you control this one based on different, for example, you can have a sensor, you can have an ultrasonic sensor, you can have temperature meter or something in a combustion chamber that you can control the flow of air or a chemical. So this can be used pretty good with controlling the servo to open or close or move some arm or something. The project is called Sweep. So you go File, Examples, and scroll down Servo, and then you will get Sweep. Open the Sweep. I've already opened it. That is the Sweep. So the servo is now connected the same way as before to the pin 9 here. And this is a for loop which goes between the position initially, which is from 0 to 180 degrees. And this is increasing, this plus you can see here. So it goes, remember 0 was here, it goes to 0 to 180 degrees. Okay, so this is going for one step at a time. And then this one goes from position 0, so it starts at 180 and this is being subtracted. So once it moves here, then it goes from 180 slowly 1 degree down, and every time it goes for 15 millisecond delay. So let me upload it. So it starts from 0 to 180 and from 180 to 0. Now this is very precise because we are going 1 degree here. If you pay attention, this is 1 degree. And also this is 1 degree. So this is 1 degree increase, that is 1 degree decrease. Let me just change that. Let's say you want to make it 10 degrees and 10 degrees decrease. Let me upload it again. Now you will see it will jump to make it a little interesting. Let me have 100 milliseconds. 100 milliseconds means 1/10 of a second. So let's upload it. Let's make it 30 degrees. I'm making it 300 milliseconds. So as you can see, it goes fully 180 degrees. If I put the pen, you will see. Okay, this was the brief introduction for using the servo with Arduino. If you like these videos, please thumb up. And also, all the code for this project and all other projects are available at robojax.com/learn, or the link is at the description of this video. Thank you.